Good morning, friends. Welcome to An Academy Cat Life Daily. Yes, guys, please join me for another class. It is known as a verbal ability workshop. Yes, we are doing a verbal ability workshop. And what is a workshop? A workshop is a class where we will do a multiple variety of questions of different types. Yes, guys, all kinds of question types coming up for you today. It is going to be a very exciting class. So just join me as soon as possible and let's get cracking. We need to get very serious. The CAT examination is round the corner, guys. So let us go into the formalities. My name is Harpreet Kaur Dhodi. I have done my master's in English literature. I have 16 years of teaching experience. I've trained students for the exams like the CAT, MAT, ZAT, SNAP, PGCET, Banking, GRE, GMAT, SAT, ACT and TOEFL. Yes. I have done a diploma in journalism also. I like to create content. Today, I'm an educator with hashtag CatLiveDaily, guys. Yes, agenda today is a verbal ability workshop, different types of questions. Yes, I'm trying to prepare you for any kind of question that will come in the VARC section this year, guys. So join me as soon as possible. Download the Telegram channel, livedaily.me/chat and join the Telegram chat. I have a personal Telegram group which says Harpreet Ma'am An Academy CAT, guys. Please join that group also in order to get intimation daily about what are the classes that I'm taking. I have free classes and plus classes going on simultaneously. Yes, guys, so the CAT subscription is the best in the industry. Very reasonably priced, only 1,458 for 12 months, 875 for 24 months. Yes, if you use Core 10, you will get a further 10% discount. In fact, you can use Core 10 for any of the courses on An Academy, guys. So if you have friends, sisters, cousins, brothers joining An Academy, please use Core 10. Very easy to remember. Please use the code Core 10 in order to join An Academy subscription, friends. Yes, so aaj karna hai verbal ability workshop. It is lecture 6. I have done many more verbal ability workshops earlier. All those who are taking the examination this year and need more practice with question types, please go and look at the previous ones. It will be of great help to you guys. Yes, so waiting for all my students to join in. Fatafat. Yes, good morning, Anuj. Rishi, most of the verbal ability section in the CAT is the same as the SNAP. Yes, so let us take up a course on SNAP very soon. After we finish with the CAT examination, we will do a course on SNAP also. Good morning, Saurabh, Akash, Rishi, Soumya, Rukved, Sumit, Vedant, Shikhar, Anshal, Rohit. Yes, guys, all my friends who are with me. So what do I have here today is a mixed bag of questions. We will start with critical reasoning kind of questions and go on to other questions like para jumbles, odd man out and the like. So there are many kind of questions coming up. It's going to be a very, very fruitful exercise. Stay with me, guys, so that we can continue. Yes. So Rishi Mukhopadhyay, if you're taking the CAT in CAT 2021, please join the plus courses on An Academy and use Core 10, KAUR10. Hi, Rakesh. How are you doing? Yes, Vikas. Good morning. Mohammed, Shahnawaz, Saurabh. Yes, guys. So let us go into the lesson today. The first question we are doing, first set of questions are critical reasoning questions. And I have already done some courses on critical reasoning, right? Yes. Very good, Rishi. I am amazed that you were able to get all the questions correct. Yes, so we need to practice with reading comprehension because it is one section which is definitely coming in the CAT examination. And the second aspect is that 3/4 of the VARC questions will be based upon RC, guys. So let us do more RC lessons this week, maybe multiple lessons this week. Every day morning, let us do reading comprehension classes. That is my agenda for this week, guys. Leading up to Diwali, then we will take a break for Diwali and then continue next week. Is that fine with you guys? So give me a high five if you are ready with this plan that I have. Or if you have any suggestions, please go ahead and let me know. Hi, Megha. No, Rishi, you are not late. If you are taking it next year, you are not late at all. Please join me for a course in the evenings. YouTube course will start in the evenings for CAT 2021, guys. Today is the first class, right? Yes, most of you are giving me answers, but the answers are not correct, guys. Yes, yes. Answers are not correct. The best way. So what is an assumption? An assumption is a gap between the facts leading to a conclusion. There are facts and there is conclusion. The gap there is known as an assumption. Assumption will be an unstated fact. The best way to save petrol consumed by vehicles to reward people who reward people who share rides to work with coupons for free petrol. Which of the following is an assumption? Good morning, Sakshi. Yes, what do you think is an assumption? There is no other alternative to save petrol than to reward. Is this, is he talking about another alternative, guys? No, it can't be E. Yes, E is out of scope. E is out of scope, guys. It is not the answer. He's not talking about, is he saying there is no other alternative in the passage? Remain within the scope of the passage. Don't go beyond the scope of the passage, guys. Yeah. Whatever is suggested has to be within what the author is trying to say. He's saying the best way is to reward people who share rides with coupons for free petrol. So what do you think is the answer? How do you know that majority of the people who work use vehicles? Is he suggesting that majority of people who use who work use vehicles is not an assumption? No, we don't know that majority of people who work use vehicles. That cannot be assumed. So we have eliminated A, I've eliminated E. People who use vehicles only when they go to workplaces. How do you know that only when they go to workplaces they are using vehicles? This is also not suggested, guys. D is not suggested. Yeah, so what are we left with? What are we going to be left with? No, Rugved, it is not D. Why are you guys not getting the answer is B. Vehicles have the capacity to seat one more person. That is why he is talking about sharing rides. It has to be within the scope of the argument. If they are living nearby, proximity is not suggested. Yes, proximity is not suggested, guys. He's not talking about those who live close by. Majority of people use vehicles is not suggested. They go to their workplace is not suggested. Alternative is not suggested. Yes, you get it, guys. This is the way you do assumption. If he is saying that we will reward them, he's assuming that vehicles have the capacity to seat one more person. So the answer will be B. Yes, guys. So we need to do a little more practice with critical reasoning questions. Now read this one and mark the conclusion. It is a mixed bag of questions, guys. Different kinds of questions coming up here for you. Yes. Yes, read the argument properly. Understand it. Yes, give me the correct answer, guys. Hi, Prince. Long time. Seeing you after a long time. Yes, now you are getting the hang of it. The average income this year is also expected to rise. Consequently, the deposits with the bank are likely to go up considerably. Yes, very good. Now you are giving me correct answers is D. The propensity. What is propensity? It means the inclination. Yes, or the leaning towards. Yes, we are leaning towards to save is greater than the propensity to spend. So we are more likely to save than to spend is what the author is suggesting. So that is why you are getting D. Yes, Jatin, good morning. How are you doing? Right. Yes. So if you look at income in the agricultural sector is out of context. What is he saying? That household income has increased significantly in our country. Saving money with the banks is the best saving as it is the sales and most rewarding in terms of returns. So the average income this year is expected to rise and deposits. So this is going to be a trend. If we are going to save, we will have more money. Therefore, the deposits in the bank are likely to go up. So what am I assuming? I mean, the conclusion I arrive at is there is more going to be more saving than spending this year is what the author is suggesting. Right, guys? Yes. Okay. So the political leadership of the country has no clear view regarding domestic savings. Is he talking about political leadership? Aise eliminate karna hai. Okay. Just eliminate on these basis. The incomes of residents of country compares favorable to those of non-resident citizens. This comparison is not being made. He's not making a comparison of who is making the savings. The balance of trade, which is the difference between the values of total exports and total imports, all out of scope, guys. Eliminate options, you will arrive at answers. Easy to eliminate, right, Rishi? Okay, so then give me correct answers. Pehla wala galat ho gaya. Now all answers have to be correct. Read it carefully. Now you have to weaken the argument. So what do you do in weakening the argument? You have to contradict the conclusion of the author. And you can bring an element from the outside to weaken the author's conclusion. Right? So the conclusion is given here. Laws of some countries mandate riders of two-wheelers to wear helmets to protect themselves from head injuries in the event of an accident. These laws are opposed to those who feel that the individuals must have the right to decide for themselves whether to wear the helmets or not, as not wearing helmets does not affect them. So, laws are opposed to the, some people feel that it is my head. I want to decide whether I want to wear a helmet or not, or whether I want to be safe or not, is what the author is saying, which is contradictory to what the laws are saying. Yes, guys, Soumya, please like my videos. 44 students, please like the videos. It's very, very encouraging for the educator to see that students liked your videos. Sahil, that is speaking from experience, right? Yeah, you're speaking from experience. Yes. I'm getting different answers, guys. You have to contradict this one. You have to contradict this one. If the laws are opposed to what people feel is they have the right to decide whether they want to wear a helmet or not. Yes, what will be the answer? Very good. Some of you are giving me correct answer, but still some of you are not clear. Yes, you need to have clarity of thought. You will get all answers correct on critical reasoning, guys. Yes, Shikhar. Shikhar, Ankit, giving me correct answers. Yes, guys, it will be E. So if you think it is my head and I can decide whether I want to choose to wear it or not, insurance rates for two-wheelers are higher because of the higher incidence of injuries and deaths in two-wheeler accidents where drivers don't wear helmets. So really you don't have a choice because the insurance rates are going to shoot up, right? Yes. So that is what he is trying to say, is not wearing a helmet by drivers of two-wheelers does not harm others. So the statement that proves it causes harm is the one which will weaken it. Not wearing a helmet by drivers results in more accidents, leading to more insurance rates for all, causing harm to others. So if you are bothered about your head, you are causing the insurance rates to go up and that is going to impact everyone. Do you understand that? Yes, that is why it will be E, guys. E is the one which contradicts this conclusion. Yes, you can say I can do what I want to. But by doing what you want to, you're causing the accidents to go up and impacting insurance rates, which ultimately impacts everyone. right? Yes. So if you say there are similar provisions regarding seat belts for car drivers, it is out of context. He is not talking about car drivers. There have been more fatal accidents involving two-wheelers driven by persons is just a fact. Does not make sense. Yes. Yes, Megha, let me explain. Okay, there are two aspects to this argument. First one is saying that the laws are saying you have to wear helmets, right? I am saying it is my decision, it is my right, it is my head. Whether I want to choose to wear a helmet or not is the author's conclusion. So, author is saying that people should have the right to decide whether they want to wear a helmet or not, right? Yes. Not necessary, Rugved. It's not necessarily negative. Right? Okay. So, I have to contradict this conclusion or weaken it. You are saying that it is my right whether I want to wear a helmet or not. But if you don't wear a helmet and all of us don't wear helmets, the number of injuries on two-wheelers will go up and therefore the insurance rates will go up, and the insurance rates impacts everyone, not only me. It impacts everyone, and therefore to say that it is my decision and it does not affect others. So wearing helmets does not affect others. Of course it affects others is what he is telling you. It affects others. Why? Because you are causing the insurance rates to go up for everyone. Now, do you understand? Now, let me give you a simple example, guys, for weakening. Yes. Supposing I have been giving this example over and over again in every class so that you remember the example. So, if we say that, you know, children go to school at 9 and come back at 4 in the evening, let us have them go at 8 and come back at 2 so that they can come in the afternoon, go to sleep and pursue extracurricular activities in the evening. If there is an option which is saying children come home and waste their time and watch television, then it is weakening the conclusion. So an option which weakens or contradicts the conclusion is known as weakening. An option which supports the conclusion is known as strengthening. Right? Yes, now it is found that pillion riders are people who sit at the back of a vehicle. He is not talking about pillion riders. He is talking about people who are driving. Though there are laws mandating wearing of helmets, compliance enforcement. Compliance means forcing people to follow is out of context. How easy it is to eliminate options, guys, if you read into the entire option and you will get the answers correct. Okay, going to question number 4. Now you will give me the correct answer because this is strengthening. You have to strengthen the author's conclusion. Read the passage and tell me what will strengthen. Yes, easy one. Support the conclusion. That's all you need to do. Hi, Purnima. How are you? Yes, now you got it. Don't mark true answers, guys. Mark correct answers. In critical reasoning, the correct answer is what the author says. It may or may not be true. Yes, don't mark true answers. Mark the correct answer. Yes, guys, everyone giving me the correct answer. D is the answer. Nutrients contained are more easily absorbed. So it is giving you one more reason why you should take a well-balanced diet, right? So D is supporting by saying why you should take a well-balanced diet. So D will be the answer. The contention of the manufacturers is a true answer. It is not a correct answer. Yes. And whether it is true or not is not impacting the conclusion. We have to support the conclusion. Author is saying that instead of taking a drink, if you take a well-balanced diet, you will get all the nutrients. And D is telling you nutrients contained in a diet are mostly absorbed by the body more effectively. Now, this is talking about the flavor of the drink, easy to eliminate flavor of the drink, right? The children who were used to taking food drink do not take natural food in these nutrients is not suggested. Children look forward to variety, out of scope. So answer is D, guys. So by the fourth question, you have got a hang of how to do critical reasoning. Very good. Keep going, guys, and see that you give me correct answers. Think critically, analyze, and mark the answers. Coming to question number 5. Inference. I've given you all kinds of questions. We did assumption, conclusion, weakening, strengthening, and now we are doing inference. Mixed bag of critical reasoning questions and more interesting questions coming up, guys. Stay with me. Yes, all 47 students watching, please like my videos. And also, if you're planning to join an academy, use KAUR10, guys, KAUR10. Yes, those who are planning to take the CAT next year, please go ahead and join. What is an inference? Inference is something which is derived from the given facts and conclusion. Very good. Yes, Sahil, Rishi, Prasanna, Rugved, Shikhar, Saurabh. Yes, answer is C. Very good. Producing salt from Australian rock deposits is the best way to make salt that has a longer shelf life and is better for health is what he's trying to say here also. He's trying to say it is better for health and longer shelf life than ordinary salt because iodine reduces the amount of moisture and the level of iodine is best in what is found in Australia. So another conclusion that can be arrived at here will be definitely C, guys. C is the answer. Salt produced from Australian salt deposits contains the highest level of iodine found in any salt. Now he is comparing this salt to other salt and that is why A is not correct. Yes, so this is not correct, guys. Then this is talking about other ways of producing salt. So a large amount of salt is likely to form lumps is not what is suggested. And salt that is from Australia is likely to be hazardous to health is the opposite of what the author is saying. Salt from Australia is better than any other country is not the comparison that he is making. Right? So answer will be C, guys. I'm going to go to the sixth question. Find the flaw. How to choose best option fit more than correct? Rishi. Correct answer is what the author says always. Yes, yes, you must read Alpana into the entire sentence. Read into the entire sentence. You have to, otherwise you can go wrong. Yes, what is wrong with this argument, guys? Identify the flaw in the argument. Why can't it be? Because a large amount of salt produced is less likely to form lumps is not what he is telling you. He is saying that it is likely to be better for health and have longer shelf life. Right. Not that it is less likely to. So this one is talking about something which is not likely to form lumps. That is not the idea he is saying. He is saying it is free flowing but not B. Yes. Can't be B. Yes, coming to sixth one. What is wrong with the argument? You have to find the flaw with the argument, guys. What is wrong with this argument? Change your approach to the question. Yes, don't all the time look for conclusion and inference. Change your approach. Just read the argument and understand what is absurd about this argument. What is their argument trying to suggest which is flawed? Yes, now some of you are giving me correct answers. Yes, Shriya, Samir, Anshal, Ankush, Sahil. Yes, the answer is correct. So first he starts off by telling you that students who attend engineering college with 1-to-1 student ratio have better placement prospects. But he is only in the conclusion saying, go and join a college with a small student population. Small student population does not ensure better student and computer ratio. We also have to see how many computers are there, right? Just having a small population is not enough. We have to see what is the ratio of student to computer. So that is why it will be C. Yes, this is talking about placements should be considered. He's not talking about placements in the passage. Yes, this also is talking about high placement. Engineering aspirants rarely follow sound advice is not suggested. There are no engineering colleges in the US. Easy to eliminate, guys. C is saying that you have to check both the student and the computer ratio is important. Okay, guys. So I'm going to go to the seventh one. Now we are doing para jumbles. Yes, mixed bag of questions for you guys today. Very interesting set of questions. Please go ahead and look at this one, para jumbles. Yes, we are doing a verbal ability workshop. So I have brought you different kinds of questions. A slightly long one, but it is a CAT type of a question. Yes, A is the opening sentence. Yes, we can start with A, guys. A is the first sentence. You're saying AC is a pair? No. But confidence in its future and its enduring value. Maybe beginning to crack along economic lines according to major surveys of the American public. Right. Yes, I'll give you 5 minutes, guys. Form the whole passage. Yes, yes. Form the whole passage. Yes, I'm getting some correct answers. Very good. Yes, by now the whole combination should be correct. Yes, you're doing well, Rishi. AD is okay. A is followed by D. Right? Yes, so you say A is followed by D definitely. Public anxiety over college cost is an all-time and low-income college graduates burdened by student loan are questioning the values of the degree and saying the cost of the college has delayed their life decisions. So this is also negative. This is negative, this is also negative, right? So A is followed by D, correct. A, D, and then A, D, E, correct. A, D is followed by E. Yes, among college presidents, the rising price of college is not the only worry. We are concerned about growing international competition, another worry, right? So this is one worry, this is another worry that he's talking about, A, D, E. And now it will be lastly, if I see, it will be CB, guys, not E, BC, C. But perhaps the most troublesome finding of this survey. Now look at the conclusion. More than a third of the presidents link the industry they lead is heading in the wrong direction without a change in course. Now this is the wrong direction. That is why C has to be followed by B and not B by C. Yes. So there is a change in course is relating to the direction which is mentioned in C. Do you see that, guys? Yes, Shikhar was the one to give me the entire combination correctly. A, D, E, C, B, guys. Great. You're all doing great. 45 students watching. Please like my video, guys. I put in a lot of effort to bring these classes to you. Yes, going to question number 8. Yes, I'm going to give you 3 minutes. Form the whole passage. Yeah, whole combination. No, Rishi, it's not C. So, Sahil, you're close but not correct. No, guys, B is not the opening because here he is telling you people who are optimistic, but optimism is already mentioned, right? So look at general to specific paragraph. General to specific. No, it is not D, it is A. A will start the paragraph. Optimism like hope. Yes, start with A, Payal. Very good, Soumya. Yes, start with A, guys. Yukta, yes, guys, A is the opening. Purnima, this is talking about it afterwards, right? Saurabh, slightly wrong. Yes, most of you are giving me AC, which is fine. A is followed by C. From the standpoint of emotional intelligence, so it is defining optimism. After says here it is giving defining optimism and taking forward the definition. Taking forward the definition of optimism. So A and C are linked. Now A C ke baad. No, it's not B, guys. Yes, Prasanna. A C E. Okay, A C E. And with hope, its near cousin optimism pays dividends in life, provided, of course, it is a realistic optimism or too native optimism can be disastrous. Right? A, C, E, B. Now it is B. Here you're going wrong. You're saying DB. Yes, guys, you mark the first three correct and then you don't pay attention to the last two and you're going wrong there. Right? Yes. So A, C, E, B, D is the combination. Right? Okay, is that fine? Yes, because D is saying these differing explanations is the explanations which are mentioned above for how people respond to life is conclusive in nature. Tough one, Rishi. Okay, let us go to the next one. We have to do tough ones now. Why? Because the exam is close to us. Right. Abhi karenge best summary, guys. We just have 5 more questions left. Yes, 5 more questions and we are done. Best summary karna hai. Read the passage and tell me which is the best summary. Simple one. There is no apostrophe here. Done. Yes, I'm going to go to the options now. If you are done, I'm going to go to the options, guys. Yes, which is the one which is the best summary? Yes, think and answer, guys. Yes, all of you are giving me correct answer is C. This is a complete summary of the passage. Despite governmental claims, our children are exposed to toxic because of the connivance of the government regulators. And connivance means, you know, when two people or three people get together to create a negative plot, they are creating a plan or a plot, and there is a connivance between the government regulators and pesticide manufacturers, is what the author is saying, right? So you can't say they are government watchdogs. Similarly here, that the pesticides are exposed to are safe is a myth, is not suggested in the passage. Pesticides are ubiquitous, means present everywhere. The word ubiquitous, omnipresent, is out of scope. It is not mentioned in the passage, right? So that is why the answer will be C. If you have to choose between C and D, guys, we will choose C is a complete summary. Okay, now the next question going to one. Yes, see, government, our children get exposed to toxic insecticides because pesticide manufacturers influence government watchdogs. Where is he saying they are government watchdogs? He says many governments insist that our standard of protection are strong enough, right? And he's saying the EU food safety watchdog copied and posted. This is, here he's mentioning, this is the European Union, guys. Last month, it was revealed that a widely used pesticide was safe. The European Union safety watchdog copied and pasted on the page. This is giving you an example. So that is why it will not be D. D is incorrect. Okay? Are you satisfied, Samir? Yes, I'm going to go to the next one. Best summary question. One more. Yes, are you understanding the passage? Done. Okay, I'm going to go to the options, guys. Thank you. No, it is not B, guys. He is not saying that a good narration should take rigors of common man as the subject matter. He is not saying that you have to talk about the subject matter. No, it's not that always you will talk about that you should write only on rigors of life. Is he saying that we should only write on rigors of life? No, guys. Yeah. So answer will be C. Yes, a good narration should present life with objectivity, not with the bias of the narrator. So you may not write on rigors of life always. What is he trying to say here is, a narration should avoid egocentricity. Your story should not be yours alone. It should reflect every man's story. So what he's saying, we should plug away, trying to plug ourselves as a kind of man and create a narrative that resonates with our fellow human beings. It should reflect people's human beings' feelings. With a large audience, want to write a book, would touch people, encompassing not only a specific society, but humankind itself and the truth of life. Is what the author is trying to say, right? So the answer will be C, guys. Yes, so you have to talk from the point of view of the reader and not from your point of view is what is the author is trying to say. Now, egocentricity is the hallmark of narration is not suggested. A good narrator focuses on universal subjects is not suggested. Universal is different from subjective and objective, guys. Like I was telling you last time itself, now, if I'm talking about this phone and I say that this phone is red in color, it is an iPhone, it is a phone which is very usable, okay, or I'm just giving you the description of the phone. So, then I can say that, you know, this is a objective analysis, right? That is known as objectivity prasanna. I was just explaining that. So, if I'm just explaining the qualities or the features of the phone, then it is supposed to be very, very objective. But if I say this is a beautiful phone, it has the color red, I like the color of the phone, it has a camera, and you know, I'm also commenting upon the phone, then it becomes what is known as, then it becomes subjective. Subjective is when the author's emotions and feelings are involved. But objective is when he's trying to tell you things only from the point of view as they are stated as facts. Without commenting upon it, it is objective. Now, E is saying narcissism. What is narcissism, guys? What do you mean by narcissism? Have you come across this word? Yes, has anyone come across this word? What does narcissism mean? Yes, anybody knows the answer? Narcissism is a love with oneself. Narcissist was this handsome man in Greek mythology. He looked at his image in the river and fell in love with himself. So that is known as narcissism. Yes, that is known as narcissism, right? Okay. Yes. So here, objectivity means that you have to look at things from people's point of view and not your point of view. Correct? Yes. Fine. Now I'm going to go to the next question coming up on your screens. It's para-completion, guys. Para-completion. As I told you, it's a mixed bag of questions and we just have three more questions to go. Three more questions to go and we are done. Yes, what is it that will best complete the paragraph? Read the penultimate sentence. He's giving you, he's explaining elephant in the room dash organizational politics. So that is the elephant in the room, Akash. Yes, he's saying dash organizational politics. So we have to look for an option which will connect to this particular idea. Now I'm going to go to the option. Hi, Romic. Yes. What does that emoji mean? Correct. Very good. Very good. I thought you will not be able to get this answer, but you did manage it, guys. Very good. Answer is B. Now, the elephant is all pervasive is a fact which is already mentioned. It's a restatement mentioned in the passage, right? And the thing is, if you look at C and D are not mentioned. Not mentioned. So if I say the elephant is blowing its own trumpet, that means he is boasting. We are not talking about the elephant literally. The elephant is a smooth walker. No. So therefore the answer is B, guys. With a pleasing manner and hidden fangs. Elephant having fangs, it is a snake which has fangs. Pervasive means present everywhere. Yes, it is present everywhere, Shikhar. Okay. Yes, so what is he saying? He's saying is that it is there everywhere. Organizational politics is everywhere is what he's saying. Right. When we hear the phrases, such behavior exists in 25 years of, definitely 25 years of training and unspeakable horrors whispered about the elephant in the room. Organizational politics is everywhere. Right. Okay, coming to the next one is also para completion, guys. And we just have three more questions and we are done. Buoyant means being very positive. Yes, being very optimistic, buoyant, active, positively buoyant. That means he was very optimistic. It's the name of a company, just like he's talking about Celebrex. This is the name of a drug. And this is also the name of a drug company. So he's saying Pfizer and Pharmacia. Hook, line and sinker, Purnima, is an idiomatic expression, means go for something without thinking. Yes, you just go for something without thinking. And conniving means when two or three people put their head together to do something negative is the meaning of conniving. It's not C, Rishi. Don't look at answers which are off the mark. Yes, Romik and Nitya. Romik, Nitya, Anuj, Pradeep, Ankit. Yes, guys, now the correct answer is coming. Yes, the companies have a lot riding on the study. What is the last sentence telling you? Presented the results from the 6 months of year study than the whole thing, rather than the whole thing. Why are they doing all this? Celebrex, actually, the truth is that Celebrex was no better in protecting the stomach for serious complications than other drugs. It appeared that the only way, because both of them presented the results, first make 6 months of a long year study rather than the whole thing. Why? Because they had a lot riding on it. That means, yes, Rugved, what was your question? Yes, Celebrex is not mentioned. Touted as the magic formula is not mentioned. While if I say C and D are restatements, they are already mentioned in the passage. But the companies are very happy that the drug was a big hit in the market. Other similar drugs available in the market were as effective as Celebrex. Yes, answer is A, guys. A is the answer. What is the question you're asking me, Rukveda? I missed your question. Yes, A is the answer, right? Okay, so I'm going to go to the next question coming up on your screens. If you're not able to understand the whole paragraph, then look at the last sentence. Look at the last sentence and try to understand it. You cannot not understand the whole paragraph. Maybe you don't understand some words in it, Rugved. Yes, so try to understand. Improve your comprehension, because how will you do reading comprehension if you're not able to understand passages? So you have to do a lot of reading comprehension to see that you are associated with different types of question types. Now we are doing odd man out, guys. Two questions on odd man out and we are done. Yes, very, very good quality of questions that I have brought you today. Yes, high level CAT type of questions, guys. Odd man out. All of you are struggling with odd man out, right? So form the paragraph and tell me which is the odd man out. I'm going to give you 2 minutes. Rishi, you can't do odd man out this way. Guys, aise nahi hota hai. You have to form the paragraph. Yes, form the paragraph. Yes, I am getting correct answers now. Right, so form the paragraph. The first sentence is A. Let me explain to you. Compared to the movement of material goods and financial capital across the country, labor and talent have been much slower to globalize. So compared to material, now this however is referring to within the sentence itself, that movement of material goods and financial capital across countries, labor and talent have been slow to globalize. As a result, only 3% of the world population lives outside their country of birth. Right. Globalization has been a mighty force over the last few decades. So C. And then you have E. This global localization is perhaps not surprising. So that therefore it is E. Answer will be D, therefore. People and their neighbor have typically come as a collective, fully integrated package that makes location decision more complex. Is he talking about location decisions? Right? Yes, A, B, C, E, Shikhar, correct. Yes, that is the combination. Unless you form the combination, you cannot get correct answers, guys. Okay, going to the last question. You were correct, Rishi? Yes, some of you are correct. Shikhar was also correct. Rishi was correct. Yes, last question coming up on your screens. Give me a correct answer, guys, again. Yes, all the 48 students watching me, stay with me every day in the morning, guys, leading up to the CAT examination. Yes, I'm going to come up with high difficulty level questions. Purnima, you also got it. Great, guys. Yes, now at this point, we cannot do anything but practice, practice and practice. So see that you're with me every day at 9:30 in the morning. At 7 in the evening, I'm going to start a course for CAT 2021 today in the evening, guys. So join me for CAT 2021 in the evening basics. Yes, those who wants to join the PLUS program, I am doing a series of mock tests at 4:30 every day in the evening. So take your subscription with code 10 and join in, guys. No, you did not form the paragraph. How are you saying D? No, guys. Opening sentence is C. Okay, now let me do this for you. Opening sentence is C. We call ourselves Homo sapiens, man the wise, because our intelligence is so important to us, right? So start with C. Next one is E. For thousands of years, we have tried to understand this characteristic that enables us to think, right? Then you go to A. That is, now that is relating to the ability to think. We have speculated as to how a mere handful of matter can perceive, understand, predict, and manipulate a world far larger and more complicated than ourselves. So CEA. Now you go to the field of artificial intelligence goes further still. It attempts not only to understand but to build intelligent entities. Now B is talking about subfields. So as I have told you guys earlier also, by extension, the last sentence can go out of the picture and become the odd man out. Yes. So like I was giving you the example, I have a dog. It is a pug. Its name is Pitbull. It has, it is brown in color. And what else can I say? It has a red band around its neck. There are a variety of, there are many species of dogs in the world. Now I'm still talking about dogs, but I'm graduating to the next paragraph. So therefore, by extension, B will become the odd man out. Right, guys? So if you are happy with the content of my lessons between A, yes, but then A is forming the paragraph. If you don't form the paragraph, guys, you will not form the answer. Okay, now let us go into the quiz, guys. All 40 of you, please join me for a quiz. Yes, I'm going to host a quiz in a minute. So I'm going to put up the, quiz in a minute. Can we do para jumbles, guys? Today, yes, yes, I'm giving you the code in a minute. So 20 questions on para jumbles, 80 seconds each question, and here I have created the quiz, guys. All 40 of you, 681522. Yes, code here, I'm going to put it up, 681522, guys. This is going to be very, very valuable practice. Yes, 681522, jaldi jaldi join karo and I will start the quiz in a minute. 681522, guys. Yes, thank you, guys. Stay with me every day in the morning for a very fulfilling session. 681522. Yes, you're welcome, Romik. Yes, my mission in life is only make a difference in the lives of my students. I want to impact your careers. I want to make an impact on in your life. Yes, Ankit, go to the Unacademy Learner app. Unacademy Learner app pe jaake, you go on the plus courses. Okay, plus course mein click karke, niche ek icon aayega, tests. Click on the test, join the quiz with the code 681522. Yes, very good guys. Jaldi jaldi, competition is good. The more the people join, the better the competition. And para jumbles is an important question types. Ankit, samajh aa gaya? Are you able to do it? 681522. No, there are 20 questions, Soumya. Oh, shit. Okay, sorry. Okay, can I change it, guys? I think it didn't save the number of questions. Can I change it? Sorry for the inconvenience. Yes, Megha, go to the plus courses. Yes, sorry guys, there's only 5 questions, so I'm going to make a change and put up another code. Please wait for me. Yes. I'm sorry, I was trying to do it in a hurry. Yes, I'm sorry, guys. We will change the code. Code will change now. I'm just putting up the other code here. 651-566. Now there are 20 questions. 651-566. Very sorry for the inconvenience. I think it did not get saved. I was doing it in a hurry. So please join with 651-566. Yes, you can exit that group and join this group, guys. I'm very sorry. Yes, 20 questions are there, 80 seconds each. Yes, can you just tell people who are on that quiz to join here also? Please inform 651566, guys. Please switch from that quiz to this quiz. Now it's fine, Soumya. Thank you for bringing it to my attention. Sorry, Rugved. Yes, so can you please put all the comments on the Telegram app? I will answer it. Yes. Yes, thank you, Adarsh. 651566, guys. Quickly join, Karo. Yes, Rugved ko abhi manana padega. Rugved is miffed. You know what miffed means? Yes. Six, 651566, guys, जल्दी ज्वाइन करो. यस, थैंक यू रुग्वेद फॉर पुटिंग इट अप ऑन द टेलीग्राम ऐप. मिफ्ट मीन्स अ लिटिल अपसेट, नॉट फ्यूरियस. नाराज हो जाना, यस, बीइंग नाराज, या. Okay, guys, so can I start the quiz? Another one or two. There are 13 here. Let me get at least, I thought there will be at least 20 students. Yes. Okay, so can I get started? Because of the inconvenience and the delay, I'm just trying to wait for students. Yes, please send it, because the more the competition, the better will students do. Yes, more will join, Vinay. The problem is that yes, Sahil, that is some explanation that you are giving. Very good explanation. No, Megha, you don't need to take subscription to join the quiz. Quiz is free. 651566. Please join. Go to the Unacademy Learner app. Go to Plus Courses. Click on Tests and join with this code 651566. Okay, guys, I'm going to start the quiz now. All of you are joining in. Please start and concentratedly do it. All the best, and here we go. Yes, the verbal ability section. Sorry, it has changed. Yes, Italy, just change it to 651566. I'm sorry, log in again, 651566. Yes, guys, so I will end the class and go offline. Okay, Shikhar, we will do some grammar classes, definitely. So the verbal ability section is taken by me, 9:30 to 10:30, continues in the evening, 7 to 11 p.m. on hashtag CatLiveDaily. Download the Telegram app, livedaily.me/chat. I have my own Telegram group. It says Harpreet Ma'am, Unacademy Cat. Guys, join me there. Cat subscription is the best in the industry. There are live classes, interact with the educator, live polls, leader poll, test series, analysis, live doubt clearing sessions. Yes, step one is join the Unacademy learning app. Install the app. Go for the plus courses. There are many courses. Get your subscription. Cat subscription is the best in the industry, guys. 1,458 for 12 months, 875 for 24 months. Core 10, use karo please for any of the courses. Any course that you take on Unacademy, whether it is NEET, JEE, 9, 10th, 11th, 12th, not only Cat, guys. Please go ahead and use Core 10. Like, share, hashtag CatLiveDaily, download the PDF. Use Core 10, guys, to subscribe, and see you again in the evening at 7 p.m. today. Bye-bye. Take care. All the best.